Hi, my name's Peter Smythe. I'm a maths and science teacher at Gungahlin College. Last year, I noticed that one of my math classes wasn't working the way I wanted it to be, and I needed to take some action to address that. And the obvious place of ideas seemed to be the students. So I asked them for feedback, and they were quite happy to tell me the things I was bad at and the things that I actually did which helped them with their learning.
Peter, when we normally had class last semester, he always talked for a very long time. So by the time we actually finished talking, we had about like 20 minutes at most to finish off the work.
Well, the thing that they told me is stop standing next to a whiteboard and talking at us because it's of no value. And please continue hanging over my shoulder and helping me with a question, or sitting down at a table with a small group of us and helping us with the questions that we're actually struggling with. And it seems kind of obvious, but until I had the students telling me that, I was choosing not to see it, I guess. One of the things I really value is student voice, and I think we talk a lot about student voice, but if you're not seen to act on what students say, it has no purpose. So I think one of the real successes in how I've changed my classroom around is that it has been in response to what students have told me. They've made suggestions and then been really surprised because changes have actually taken place in a big way, but directly related to the feedback that they've given. So instead of standing next to a whiteboard and talking in class and taking half an hour to deliver what in my mind was 5 minutes worth of content, I used video. The videos would look like literally a blank canvas with maths seemingly magically appearing in my hand, but I'd provide a commentary, which I think really gives an added layer to enable students to get a deeper understanding of not just what is happening, but why things are happening as well.
A number of times, so I'll be quick. This has the length y of pi on 6, which is equal to -1/2. Exactly the same thinking, but we're using that form rather than this.
Those videos are hosted by YouTube, but I have put links back into our virtual learning environment, our class homepage. And that's really important for me because it allows me to see when students access particular resources.
But by having the YouTube videos, it means that we actually have time to work in class without having to do the work at home.
And Peter's managed to condense 30 minutes worth of work into a 2-minute video. And that it actually makes a lot more sense. And if you don't understand it, like, you can pause it and try and it's usually really clear.
Watching the videos in our own time allows us to, like, pause, rewind, like, build on the concept of understanding what needs to be done. And class time is mainly focused on working on these problems, using the theory we've learned, and asking for help and building our skills too.
I found using our virtual learning environment and things like YouTube videos was a really powerful way of shifting things which would perhaps beforehand happen in class into a virtual space and a virtual environment. You know, buying me real time with students. Yeah, making these changes in my classroom, it's just been a revelation for me. I actually feel like students are learning, and some days I'd get that, and some days I wouldn't. But I walk into a classroom environment like the one that you've seen today, and there's no doubt in my mind that high quality learning is taking place. And there are discussions that are happening at a high level, and there's higher order thinking happening. And to see that happening in your class and know that these students are being enriched, but they're also learning skills about self-management, self-assessment, that's been really enriching for me. Yeah.
What are the defining features of an effective lesson plan? Do teachers in your school value student voice or feedback? How can IWBs be used to effectively and efficiently support student learning and engagement?